Hi, it's Adam from Mentor Collective, and I'm going to say a few words about Transfigured Night, or Verklärte Nacht, the string sextet by Arnold Schoenberg that appears on our new record, The Center Is Everywhere. This is one of those pieces that is a real kind of Mount Everest for performers, I think. It's incredibly difficult, incredibly complex, and there's this remarkable musical journey that I think both the performers and the listeners go through. So it's pretty special. Schoenberg writes this piece in 1899, so it's right at the turn of the century, and in a way, the piece, I suppose, marks the end of an era and the start of a totally new musical landscape. Transfigured Night is a piece that tells a story. It's based very specifically on a poem by Richard de Mel, which is basically about a midnight confession. The poem is about a couple who walk through the woods at night, and the woman confesses to her partner that she is pregnant and that the guy is not the father of her child. And then, so she fell pregnant, and then she subsequently met this guy. And she's sort of stressed and worried, and the poem kind of ends in this scene of transcendence, as the guy says, you know, look, I mean, I love you, it's okay, I will, I want to be with you, and I will kind of love and raise this child together with you. In the poem, we see this journey from darkness, insecurity, kind of fear, complexity, through to transcendence and acceptance, I guess, of the new life together this couple are going to have. And Schoenberg, in his music, he mirrors the dramatic structure of the poem very, very closely. As the piece opens, we hear this incredibly ominous, pulsing, processional music in the second cello. It really, for me, it's super evocative of that, of the sort of slow walk through the woods at night. And when we were recording the piece, we wanted to emphasize the sort of claustrophobic and fearful nature of that music as much as possible. We mic'd the second cello up super, super close. And so when you hear, as a listener, the opening of the piece, your perspective is the perspective of a microphone that is just a couple of centimeters away from that instrument. There's very little kind of lush room sound or reverb. It's close and uncomfortable, and it kind of sets up the expectation of what's going to happen next. As the first half of the piece kind of rolls on, Schoenberg introduces more layers to the music, more complexity of the music. Often there's a lot of conflict. It's quite aggressive, quite violent. And again, the music is totally reflecting the sort of, I guess, the anguished mental lives of the protagonists in the story. And then exactly halfway through, I mean, literally, if you like jump to halfway through on the timeline, there's this kind of pivot when for the first time, the kind of guy in the poem speaks. And it's this point that the whole piece really turns on. The moment that I'm talking about takes the shape of a melody that the first cello player, that's Nick Trigstad in our recording, plays. And it's one of the most glorious and kind of noble and open and warm sort of, you know, tunes or themes that I think has ever been written for the instrument. Because Schoenberg has set this thing up of like tension, 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 he's kind of ratcheted that up for 15 minutes. When you get this release of this cello tune, this D major section, it's a very kind of special moment. And certainly as an ex-cellist, it's something that feels amazing to play. It sits really well on the instrument as well. So often you're physically uncomfortable when you're playing this music. It's very difficult. And then both physically and emotionally and kind of in the musical grammar of the piece, it's a release in every sense when we get to this moment. As the lovers in the piece resolve this conflict and kind of find a kind of peace with each other and with themselves, Schoenberg brings the musical material of the piece, which starts very, very low in the second cello part. I mean, literally, of the six instruments, it's the lowest possible, the lowest notes that can be performed with that lineup. Through the piece, there's also this transition from the low to kind of the high. And so as we get to the end of the piece, the music is rising in pitch all the time, to the point where the players aren't even playing notes, they're playing harmonics. and you get this music which is sort of glowing and transcendental and heavenly. And there's a line in the poem, I've got it here on my iPad, which is off camera. Demel writes, "Just see how brightly the universe is gleaming. There's a glow around everything." And I don't know whether Schoenberg deliberately read that line and was like, okay, great, I'm going to write some super glowy music. But as the piece kind of winds its way to a conclusion, that's what we hear, is music that is bathed in light, bathed in release, and I guess is pointing to a better future.